Amen. Oh, just stand upon your feet, please. And begin to wave your hand. Oh, unto the Lord. In the name of Jesus Christ, we pray. And all said,
amen.
And amen. Please take your peace. Amen. Amen. And amen. We give God the praise, hallelujah, for such a wonderful time as this. You know, there's something that we are missing. And we have been saying that over and over again, but I'm not hearing that so well today. Amen. I'm going to say a word, amen, and I want you to repeat after me. He is risen.
He is risen.
No, you're not getting it right. I said, repeat it after me. Amen. I haven't gotten to the second part yet. He is risen.
He is risen.
He is risen.
He is risen.
Now much better. I'm going to say he's risen. Then you respond, he is risen indeed. And indeed, you give a big fight to your neighbor. Hallelujah.
Amen.
He is risen.
He is risen indeed.
That wasn't so powerful. Let's do one more time. He is risen.
He is risen.
Hallelujah. One more time. He is risen.
He is risen.
Praise the Lord. Hallelujah. Thank you so much for your obedience. Amen. And there are yes, for such a time as this, amen. I really wish I could take my staff off, amen. But the moment you put on this, there's no way you can put it off, amen. According to our tradition. Praise the Lord. So keep finding yourself. It's all right. We're going to make it through the fire. Hallelujah. It's certainly a mission, impenetrable. We're dancing in the fire. How much more? Are we dancing in the fire yet?
No.
You ain't seen nothing yet. Tell your neighbor, say, neighbor.
Neighbor.
You ain't seen nothing yet.
Nothing.
Amen. God bless you. This morning we're going to talk about the miracle of Easter.
Amen.
Amen. The miracle of what?
Easter.
You know, so many things are going on in our world today that are bombarding even believers or Christians. What is the miracle of Easter? Easter, I'm going to dare a woman and say hallelujah.
Amen.
And this morning, you know, we're supposed to be living now, but for some reason, something has happened in Jerusalem. Amen. BBC, out of Jerusalem. Many of you might not know my song. Hide. Hallelujah. Hide. BBL. Hallelujah. This is a spiritual sanctified song. And many of you might not get it because I'm seeing something beyond what you see. A hybrid. Am I just a BBL? Praise the Lord. Are you drinking? A hybrid.
BBL.
Not a BBL. I'm a swim. Amen. I'm such a breaker. His holiness. Amen. With the inch. We will do our best to really bring it down. And the fourth will be what? The appeals of the resurrection. Amen.
Amen.
So the first one is what? The second? The third? The fourth. Hallelujah. Now take it, my neighbor. Buckle up. Ready for a ride. Hallelujah. God is going to take us somewhere. Because this is the day that the Lord has made. As we look around us, as we look at the globe, many, many are meeting today. Gathering in churches, in small places, like China, Japan, celebrating what? The resurrection of our Lord and Savior Jesus Christ. What a miracle! What a moment for us as believers to remind ourselves of what God Himself through His Son Jesus Christ did for us. Amen. So the first thing we're going to look at is the location. And because you are so quiet, I'll stay here just for a moment today. Amen. I'm not going to go through the rest. Amen. Now let's unpack this for a moment. The location of the resurrection. Hallelujah. Now, speculations were made. As many of us witnessed that on the faithful Friday, Jesus was nailed on the cross. A God who created the entire universe. The God who spoke and things came to be. Now on the cross. Powerless. Why should a God who has all things to his care come and die a shameful death like this on the cross? He did it because he loved me. He did it because he loved me. He did it because he wanted us to be saved from the consequences of sin. So on the cross, they nailed him. They pierced his heart. The moment came when the one who created everything cried, "I am thirsty." There was no water for him to drink. They spat on him. They slapped him. Why should he go through this? Just because of you. Just because of me. And finally, he cried unto God, "Allah, Allah, lama sabachthani? My God, my God, why have you forsaken me?" On the mio tibia divina. On the mio bosio. On the mio abina jaya kasa. Ne mene jui. No usine jaya day apa. Why? Because of our sins. Finally, he said, "It is finished." Committed his soul to the Almighty God. When he cried out the last cry, the Bible says that darkness covered the surface of the globe. The sun could not light through the moon. The earth could not hold the blood that was coming out from his eyes and hands. It caused an earthquake because the King of Kings and the Lord of Lords was liberating us from the wickedness of the enemy. He was setting us free. And the Bible says that the Holy of Holies, the curtains were torn apart. And then the soldiers ran for their lives. There was no one there even to bring him down. The magic as we read the text, tells us there was a rich man who had nothing to do with what had happened. Went to the tomb. Look at the places where he had just purchased. Went back to the palanquin and begged if he could bury the body in his new tomb. Brothers and sisters, today I need not say much. Christ has loved you this much. Christ has paid the price. Christ has come to set us free from the tyranny of the enemy, that you and I can be free. And when God or the Son of Man sets us free, we are free indeed. Yet, there was no one there. The disciples have fled for their lives. Only this rich man had concern about him. Pilate, the king, gave the body. And there's a word there I want us to focus on as I unpack this message. The body of Christ was placed in where? In a borrowed tomb. Hallelujah. His body was placed in a what? Borrowed tomb. On your make us have seen in our one. She says something here. And the one who let him be able to see, you know. Then it has served the king, or maybe your king, I mean the greatest of all, dies. And imagine where they will take the body to. And all those who have real witness tradition when they are just in public, the way they pull the whole earth from the east to the west, from the north to the south, that all things what belong to them. And yet, here is Jesus borrowing a tomb to be placed. Hallelujah.
Amen.
Church, there's something for us to learn. Jesus had told them that he has to die, amen?
Amen.
And after 3 days, you what? Rise up again from the grave. Hallelujah. So Jesus was saying, I need no eternal tomb. Hallelujah. Oh, you mean such a mean that in big tomb by you will see forever. Hallelujah. Now because I'm just going to take a nap. Hallelujah. And I will rise again. Brothers and sisters, the Bible says that when the rich man came, even though rich, but was concerned, not because of his money, but because of his heart. Hallelujah. How are you serving the Lord? Are you serving the Lord because of your position or your debility? Or because you are so concerned for the one who has saved your life? Jesus knew that this was what? Temporary. Hallelujah. It was temporary. Do you know that we are living on a borrowed time? And yet many of us have made it as if we're going to live on this earth forever. In fact, let me know to you, the church, that church where I pastor, some people, it's a fact. Everybody is marking a place where he or she should be buried. You catch that? The church is in a place where they have been asked to move to a location that they can go. But they are saying, so long as we have marked where we're going to be buried, and our moms and dads and forefathers and ancestors were buried here, we are not moving an inch. We will stay here and die and get buried. Church, many of us have the same mindset that despite what God has done for us, we are still living as if nothing has happened. In Jerusalem. Hallelujah. We live on a borrowed time. Maybe the situation in your life, you know that you borrow that. And let me bring it home. When you borrow something, what is the expectation of return, right? Sorry, the Usain go back. How many of you have borrowed something and still keeping it? Amen. Turn to him as a neighbor.
Amen.
It's time for return.
Time for return.
Hallelujah. Jesus legal.
that Jesus just bought.
Hallelujah. Jesus just bought. Maybe in your life, in your sickness, you are saying it's chronic.
Do you know that you just borrowed that?
Hallelujah.
It's time for you to return it.
Amen. Hallelujah. That sickness, that sleeplessness night. Amen.
And what that prayer needed.
Hallelujah.
You've given up hope. Today there's a word for you. May you see that as a borrowed moment.
Hallelujah.
That no matter how long it takes, there is a moment of what? Return.
Hallelujah.
So Jesus said, just let me borrow your tomb.
Amen. Amen.
And in fact, when his wife, Arimathea, Joseph, wife confessed, why are you doing this? Who understood the spiritual realm said, he just borrowed my tomb.
Hallelujah.
Amen. For 3 days.
And lo and behold, the third day, the Bible says that God dispatched an angel. Hallelujah.
Amen. You know, I'm not an English person, but when you hear the word dispatch, what comes to your mind? Those who are police officers or in the army. That means attention must be given what? Quickly. On the third day, Jesus had 20 disciples, but remember when they were now, they were hiding in an upper room. But no one is a clear in the spiritual and the physical realm. Hallelujah. Brothers and sisters, do you know the situation you face, the challenges in your life, whatever you are going through is momentary. Hallelujah.
Amen.
It's for a moment. It's temporary. Hallelujah.
Amen.
And you have borrowed it. Hallelujah. So if there is havoc, you say it's havoc. I just borrowed it for a while.
Hallelujah.
Because every season has an end. There is winter. There is spring. There is what? Summer. There is what? Fall. Whatever situation you have, it's a season.
Hallelujah.
It's a borrowed moment. Do you believe this?
Yes.
Jesus understood it. So when they laid him there, his word was true. He said, after 3 days, I will rise. But did they get it? None of them believe it. There are some who are sitting here now. The Bible says that by his stripes, we are healed. As soon as I say,
amen.
Hallelujah. Remember Hannah. Remember Shepherd Mason in the Bethlehem. They believed the Lord to such a point that nothing could come between them. Because they realized they were on whose radar? On God's radar. So in your situation, seize that as what? A borrowed time.
Hallelujah.
The Bible says that it was so quiet. Every Sunday morning, two women, right? Very unusual, right? Mary Magdalene and another Mary. And so that you know, Mary Magdalene was the one who Jesus had cast out what? Demons.
Hallelujah.
You see, there are many who are sitting here who don't believe in demons. And what about things are not going well in your life? Brothers and sisters, the Bible says that we are not waging war against the flesh nor the blood.
Hallelujah.
But against what? Principalities, powers of darkness in what? In high places. If you believe this, talk to Brother Daniel. Daniel prayed to God for revival and restoration. And when he prayed, the Bible says that the prince of Persia, right, withheld the response of his prayer. But guess what? God dispatched the word, once again, right? An angel.
It is my prayer that whatever you're going through this afternoon, God will dispatch his angel to come and fight for you. No wonder Psalm then realized in Psalm 46 verse 10, he said, be still and know that I am God.
God, whenever he dispatches an angel, there's nothing that can stand.
Oh, his way, hallelujah.
And on that day, dawn, Sunday morning, the angel landed,
hallelujah.
It is my prayer the angel will land in your house. The angel will land on your job. The angel will land at the particular situation where you need the most. And the greatest thing is this. God just got dispatched angels. Amen. But you know, once not forget you, they always come with a reason. Hallelujah. So when he dispatched, for instance, angel to Mary, right? And Joseph, guess what they said?
You're going to have something miraculous.
Hallelujah. The same thing happened with Elizabeth and who? Zachariah. Something took place. So whenever they are dispatched, they are coming with what? A mission. The Bible says that when he landed, there was a severe what? Earthquake. Hallelujah. Brothers and sisters, it's about time we experience the earthquake of the Lord Almighty in our situations. So Nami was sick and near my name. Hallelujah. When he landed, he went straight to the tomb. Hallelujah. So picture that with me. He got to the tomb. And he wrote.
Hallelujah.
Amen.
Brothers and sisters, what is the stone in your life? That stone may be discouragement. That stone may be doubt. That stone may be fear. That stone may be hopelessness. Whatever stone you have, the angel has come. Hallelujah.
Yeah.
He has learned to roll away every stone. If you believe it, say amen.
Yeah.
He rolled it. And I love it so much. Time will not permit. That's the way I love to teach. After he rolled it, right? This is a small stone, right? Roll it from the main, you know, to. And guess what? He laid down and sat on it. Praise the Lord. Oh, you think I'm lying? Read the text. Hallelujah. Brothers and sisters, there is victory in Jesus Christ. Whenever he comes to us, whenever we open up our doors to him, he comes and rolls away every stone in our lives. And hallelujah. Practically, if as a deity, you subsist in his feet, to say, maybe there was an issue of a light. And in our own in our tradition, I would say the midnight, and that's what they say, the midnight. We know the application. Unless you kill a bull or a sheep, before Nana can lift the head, hallelujah. Nana put up the day. No, Nana swear, hallelujah. God is angry with the enemy. God wants your good. And what you have done for. God wants you to prosper. That is why he says in Jeremiah 11, for I know the plans I have for you. Plans that will give you hope and the future. Jesus, through the angel, rolled it and sat on it. Hallelujah.
Amen.
You know what he was saying here? Come. Amen. Come and see what the Lord is able to do. And the Bible says that the soldiers who were there freed. Hallelujah. Hallelujah.
Amen.
Now, Obiam, if somebody has died, why don't you leave the person alone? Yet they put some soldiers to guard the tomb, right? Now, my mind is saying, because I live there, don't speak fancy, but the fancy has to be really fancy. Not certainly there. Said, if I'm going to leave, now where we are, and I saw the soldier now we are. Hallelujah. Why are you putting guards around the tomb? Brother says, there's a secret here. When you are saved, when you believe in Jesus Christ, don't think it's all over. Hallelujah.
Amen.
The devil knows that you are powerful. Because of the power of God. Therefore, the Bible says that the devil was like what? A lion seeking someone to what? Devour. He will never leave. He will come attacking you. Amen. But guess who was sitting on the throne? Jesus Christ, the angel. The spark from the Most High God. So the angel sat there and said, come. Whosoever wants you, come. The soldiers freeze. It is my prayer. That anybody who has any evil intention against you will freeze up. Hallelujah.
Yeah.
Will freeze up.
Yeah.
Why didn't Jesus himself roll the stone? Hallelujah.
Because I'm trying to build you up so that you can answer some of these basic questions that are challenging our minds today. Many are questioning, why didn't Jesus move the stone? You know what? If he had moved the stone by himself, they would not have believed him. Amen. For instance, if you have an accident and you call 911, when 911 gets to your place and there's nothing there, nobody there, what do you think they will do? They will go back. And if they have your phone number, they will call you back and charge you. Amen. For misusing the hour or the time that they have to come. So, in other words, in order to have a witness, you must be present. Hallelujah. So, Jesus was there in the tomb. And it was for Mary and Martha to look through to see what was inside. And the Bible says that the cloth that was on him, the way it was folded was exactly. You know why? Because when he was being buried, who was there? Mary Magdalene and Mary. They were sitting by the tomb. And they saw exactly how he was what? Right. So they knew it. There was something that had taken place. So they look. And the angel said, now go quickly. Tell the disciples that he has risen. They should meet him where? In Galilee. But guess what happened? Jesus had told them the same words before his death, right? And left him. And as soon as they left, Jesus surrounded them. Amen. And said, woman, they bow in worship. And Jesus said, don't be afraid. Did you catch that? Don't be afraid. Church, is there any fear? We live in time of economic uncertainty. Challenges are everywhere. Maybe you are saying there is no hope for you. But I would like to invite you as I end to repeat and to really confirm this with your spirit. Paul says this, we are have prayers for the way on every side. Maybe in your life, you are so heartbroken, there seems to be no hope. But God is saying there is a miracle of Easter, the power of Easter coming your way. We are what? Not crushed. Hallelujah. Maybe in your spirit, you feel so crushed. But the Bible says, as Paul experienced it, we are perplexed, but not what? In despair. Persecuted, but not forsaken. Struck down, but not destroyed. Always carrying in our body the dying of the Lord Jesus, that the life of Jesus also what? May be manifested in us. Hallelujah. Amen. This is our testimony. This is our hope. Easter, the power of hope. Hallelujah. Never give up hope. There is hope among the dead. When they finally caught the vision, and Jesus said to them, now, I don't want you to go and tell my disciples. Go tell my brothers. You see the language? I love it. That is why I'm laughing in the Bible. When you read, don't just jump over the verses. Because grammar is the key in studying the word. He said, now go tell my disciples, my brothers. You know what? When you have a relationship with God, you no more become an enemy or just a friend. You become what? A brother. That is why the Bible says that we are heirs with who? And we are joined heirs with who? Hallelujah. We are brothers with Jesus Christ. And if you are the brother of President Obama, guess what? If you will be here in the church, you are spirit around you. Hallelujah. If you are the brother of somebody in high esteem in America, you always have a guard. Guess who is your guard? The angel of the living God. The Bible says that he sends forth his word. His angels come to guard and camp around us. Today, your angel has been dispatched. Your angel has been dispatched. The question is, do you believe this? Do you believe this? Then why don't you stand up on your feet and believe the miracle, the power of Easter that he has declared and dispatched his angel to take charge of your over your situation. That is the power of his name. So today, there has been a dispatch. There has been a dispatch. Whatever situation you are in is a borrowed situation. If it is a sickness, you are borrowed that sickness is time to give back. And it's over. I borrowed that for a reason. Let the man who borrowed that system in my mouth. Hallelujah. Remember the song when Jesus said, by his stripes we are healed, and because of our poverty, he became poor in order for us to be what? Rich. And because of our weakness, he became weak in order for us to be what? Strong. So whatever weaknesses, whatever struggles you face, may you seize that as a borrowed moment. And today, I want you to return everything to the enemy. Tell the enemy, now God has made you rich. God has made you strong. So you give everything back to him in the name of Jesus Christ. There is an earthquake taking place now. Remember when Silas and Paul were in prison and they were praising God in the midnight hour. There was an earthquake. God dispatched his presence out of worship. Here, there has been a dispatch. May you receive it now. May you receive it now. May you receive it now. Just receive it now. Without a doubt. Without a doubt. For the Bible says that whosoever doubts will never get any good thing from the Lord. For the lesson, Lord, study of the drop was in the name. So, I come at the pre-pum. No one near me, I shall come and be proper character. They were so steady. A man shared. They were unusual. But they had experienced the most incredible relationship with the Son of God. That even when the disciples could not stand, they were the ones who stood for Jesus Christ. And they experienced the first witnesses of the resurrection. What is your story? I want you to pray. I'm not going to pray for you. I want you to take that authority. Because if you have a relationship with God, the authority has been given to you. I don't want you to be afraid. Because it's not about you. It's about the power of God. It's about the power of God. His influence in that situation. Remember when Shadrach and Meshach, when and Abednego were about to be cast into the burning furnace. They said something that touched my heart so much, and I was grateful. They said, if our God will not even save us, we will never bow down to you. Brothers and sisters, can you say the same thing this afternoon? That even if something happens, if people deny you, if all the immigration stuff with the fear, if all these things don't come together, I know my God shall bring me through. I know my God will resurrect every dead thing in my life. Do you believe this? Why don't you?